name was John. He had no great abilities or uncommon qualities. He did not stir the multitudes. He did not drive a Porsche. He could not order his meals in French. Of course, he took his children to the ball game and to the zoo whenever he could, and that was to his credit. But he was an honest man, and that was to his discredit. Every morning, he stumbled out of bed, brushed his teeth, put on his tie, gulped his coffee, bid his wife and children goodbye, purchased the morning paper, and squeezed onto the rush hour subway, off to another day at work. Then, one day, a change came over him. Like us, he gradually recognized within his heart a tinge of dissatisfaction, which grew and grew and grew until finally, at the end of another exhausting day of quiet desperation, he cried out from the depths of his soul,
"My Lord, how can I serve you?"
That night he came home, and disturbed as he was, still he tried to relate to his family as though nothing were wrong. But he was not very good at pretending. Finally, he called them together and spoke to them, hoping that they would understand. Then, one day, John saw a beautiful demeanor revealed great knowledge. He spoke to John warmly and lovingly, with great compassion.
My dear boy, why are you in so much distress? How can I help you?
I sense that I'm about to die, and others are too. This I know from experience. After death, I fear that I will be punished for my sinful deeds. I don't want to die, and I'm afraid of being punished.
Do you see that lotus gateway off in the distance?
No, I don't.
Don't you see the shining light in that direction?
I think I do.
A few times he strayed off the path and was almost killed, but each time he was saved by his master. Once, while traveling through the valley of death, he saw a terrifying ogre approach. The name of this demon was Psychedelic, and he appeared to be quite mad.
Well, well, well. What do we have here?
Afraid for his life, Devotee did not know whether to go forward or retreat. As Devotee entered the city, a large congregation of effulgent beings, led by the spiritual master, clothed in radiant robes, greeted him and congratulated him over his victory of this material world and his successful entrance into the city of God.
This pilgrim has come from the city of sin. Out of love for the Lord, he has endured all kinds of tribulations.
This is the man who has loved our Lord with his whole heart, body, and mind. He has left all for the sake of the Lord's holy name. And now he desires to see the Lord face to face.